Those protesters, some of them, those there, they were singing America's national anthem.
Days ago, in Hong Kong, nearly 2 million marched in peaceful protest against a bill that would further empower the Chinese Communist Party. The now suspended extradition bill threatened to give China's central government unprecedented powers to arrest and prosecute dissidents against the Communist Party, even in Hong Kong and other areas that currently have some claim to sovereignty. But underlying that dispute is a profound moral and spiritual story that you may not have heard. 2 months ago, it was reported that a Christian hymn, Sing Alleluia to the Lord, had become the anthem of the Hong Kong protests. The hymn is not only Christian, but American, written by an Indiana woman in 1974. And last week, another anthem broke out among protesters in Hong Kong, the United States National Anthem. What's more, the American flag has become a symbol of freedom in some protests, according to a National Review report, with protesters carrying signs saying, "We need the Second Amendment," and appealing to President Donald Trump for support. All of this should come as no surprise to American Catholics. The Chinese Communist Party brutally persecutes Christians, Uyghur Muslims, and other religious people. But according to Pope St. John Paul II, the Catholic Church teaches that the right to religious freedom upholds the justification of all other liberties. And Pope Benedict XVI called religious freedom the most cherished of American freedoms. It's no wonder that those facing the threat of the atheistic and oppressive Chinese Communist Party would turn to America and the Church for inspiration and support. Or that American Catholics across the nation now stand in solidarity with the Hong Kong protesters and pray for their freedom. This has been an episode of CVTV. Subscribe to CVTV on YouTube, follow us on Facebook and Twitter, and sign up at catholicvote.org/loop.